Good morning students, I welcome you to the English class. In the previous classes of English, we have studied about the nouns and how to use the nouns in different places and in the different sentences. Today, let us study about the pronoun. Pronouns. Then what is pronoun? Pronoun is a word that is used in the place of noun to avoid the repetition of the noun. Got it? Pronoun is a word. It is used in the place of the noun to avoid the repetition of the nouns. For example, I will write one sentence. Please observe that. Priya is a student of third standard. Priya is dancing. Priya is singing well. Priya is playing games. Here I have written some sentences. Priya is a student of third standard. Priya is dancing. Priya is singing well. Priya is playing games. How do you feel when you hear these sentences? Many times I have used Priya. It doesn't sound nice. Instead of Priya to use many times, I can use the word she. Priya is a student of third standard. She is dancing. She is singing well. She is playing games. Here I have to use the word she instead of Priya many times. This word she is called as pronoun. Understand? Pronoun is a word to use in the place of noun to avoid the repetition of the nouns. Like this, the same way we can use the pronouns he, she, it, they, we, them, etc. These are the pronouns. Now we have to make the group of the pronouns. First one is personal pronouns. Personal pronouns. Personal pronouns. Here, I, we, you, he, she, it, they. I, we, you, he, she, it, they. These are the personal pronouns. And these personal pronouns, we can divide it according to the family of the members, like a family of the members. Here, I, we, you, these are called as a singulars. You, he, she, it, they are the personal pronouns. And we can use it in a another way. For example, I am talking about myself, I. And when I am talking about myself, I can use the other words also. Me or the mine. When I am speaking about you, you, yours. She, her, hers. We, us, ours. He, him, his. It, its. They, them, theirs. Like this also we can use whenever it is necessary in the sentences. And this Here, when we are speaking about the pronouns, I told you that personal pronouns. These pronouns can be divided into three persons. That is, first one is first person. First person. First person. When we speak, the speaker is called as the first person. Here I am talking. I am the first person. And the second person, second one is second person. Second person means the person spoken to or with whom we are speaking in front of us. They are called as second person. For example, you. And the third person. Third person. Third person is the person or things about whom we are talking. Which something is to be said about them. We don't know. Not I or you. They are somebody else. We are speaking about them. They are called as third person. For example, he, she, they, it. We are speaking about somebody else. Like this, we are dividing this as a first person, second person, and a third person. Now, through the examples, through the worksheet, you will understand how to identify the pronouns and the persons. Now we will see the worksheet, which is in the page number 39. One or two examples I will write it here, children. Please observe that. Sentences, pronoun, and persons. She sings a very sweet song. She sings a very sweet song. Here in this sentence, she sings a very sweet song. Here pronoun is she. And she is in which person it indicates? It indicates third person. Then you should write third here. God the Father loves us all. Loves us all. Here the pronoun is us. Us is now, once again it is a first person. Us. Us, we are talking about ourselves. God is protecting us, protecting everybody of us. We are speaking about ourselves. It is called as first person. The same way, I bought this shirt yesterday. Here, the pronoun is I and the person is first person. He wrote a letter to the officer. He is the pronoun and it is a third person. What about you here? You is the pronoun and it is a second person. All of you should read these sentences and should write it in the blanks. Which is the pronoun and which person is it? Now let us see, rewrite these sentences using pronoun. I told you in the beginning, pronoun is a word which is used in the place of noun to avoid the repetition of the noun. So, we have to use these pronouns in the sentences. First one, you see, birds make nest in the trees and the birds live in the nest. Here, how many times the bird is used? Two times. Now, we should not use these birds two times. We should avoid it and use the pronoun. Birds make nest in trees and they live in the the nest. Instead of birds, we can use it as a they. Mohan is a good boy, but I don't like Mohan. Mohan is repeated 2 times, so we have to use Mohan is a good boy, but I don't like him. For the boys, we are using the word he, him. The girl was dancing and the girl fell over. The girl was dancing and the girl fell over is there. So instead of the girl, we can use it she. She fell over. Daddy was angry with Ritu and daddy scolded Ritu. Here 2 nouns are repeated. So to avoid this repetition, we can write like this. Daddy was angry with Ritu. Daddy was angry with Ritu and he scolded her. Moon shines at night, but the moon has no light of its own. Moon shines at night, but it has no light of its own. Take this pencil and keep this pencil safely. Take this pencil and keep it safely. Susan can touch the fan because Susan is very tall. How we can use this? Susan can touch the fan because she is very tall. Like this, we can use the pronouns in the different sentences to avoid the repetition of the nouns. Now next one you see. Find out the pronoun in each sentence. Write it in the blank. Also write the noun for each it stands. Here we should see which are the pronouns and which are the nouns. Sentences. Nouns, pronouns. The sun is hot. It gives us light. Then 2 columns are here, which is noun and which is pronoun, we should write. The sun is hot, it gives us light. Here, which is the noun? Sun. And which is the pronoun? It. It. The same way, other sentences also are here. See them. Mummy is very angry with you, Ritu. Here, noun is Ritu and pronoun is you. Anne brought an apple. It was sweet. Here noun is Anne and the pronoun is it. Here comes the king. He looks sad. The noun is king and pronoun is he. Rima is a good girl. She is fair. Rima is noun. She is pronoun. Here is a chair. It is made of wood. Chair is a noun and it is a pronoun. Atul is a good boy. He is my friend. Atul is noun. He. The word he is pronoun. Like that, you should divide this noun and the pronouns in the different columns. Here are some questions. You have to answer for that. What is a pronoun? Give 4 examples. What is meant by first person? Give 4 examples. What is meant by second person? Give these examples. What is meant by third person? Give 4 examples. Now all of you listen this lesson about the pronouns and the different persons. You have to answer for these questions and send it to us. We will give you in the PDF, see the answers and write them. And some of the important things I want to say in these lessons. While talking, you are using some words. but the pronunciation of the words are wrong. That is first and foremost minds, mind, but you are using the word minds. Minds is a wrong word. Minds, this is wrong. Many times we have heard minds. It is minds, ma'am, it is minds you are saying, but it is a wrong word. Minds word you should not use, only mind. And one more thing, that is thems. Thems is a wrong word. Theirs, they are, that is theirs. Then only the grammar will be correct. What words or which are the pronouns you are using, you have to use it in a correct manner. Then only the sentences will be correct. So far what mistake you have done, forget it. But hereafter use these words, minds, theirs, like these words. They use it correctly. I hope all of you understood this and all of you are using these pronouns wherever it is necessary in a correct manner. Thank you.